What's up, everybody? It's your boy Dtlf
and your girl Yesi,
and we're here with another episode of Late Night with Dtlf and Yesi.
Yeah.
Hey, and you guys voted for this on Twitter, man. So we're gonna have a little horror episode, and it's not even October, you know. So that's the cool part. We're gonna talk a little bit about some horror movies and other things that we're gonna disclose later on in the episode. But first, I want to say how you guys are doing. What up, Search? Good to see you, my boy.
What up?
Lakers Zen, we see you, man. Sandoval, what up, guys? Hopefully you guys are strapped in, man, for this episode, because we were just watching a horror movie the other day, right?
Mm-hmm. I guess you could say a horror movie.
I mean, it's by genre, it's a horror movie.
It's considered.
And
it was more of a comedy. Yeah, it was a joke.
But what was the movie? Tell them what the movie was.
Jeepers Creepers Reborn.
Jeepers Creepers Reborn. Have you guys seen that movie? If you haven't, don't. It's a joke of a movie, but it got us to think. We wanted to do a horror episode, and you guys did vote for this episode tonight on Twitter. So it got us to thinking, what are some of our favorite horror movies we have seen? And
no, but first of all, what ratings do you give the Jeepers Creepers movie?
Oh my,
because look. The first one, we love the first one, right?
Yeah.
That was like a classic. But then the second one was all right.
Yeah.
And the third one, we were like, you know what? Let's give it a try.
Well, the first Jeepers Creepers movie is, I think, the best one. If y'all seen it, right? Chat, what up, Die Hard? Good to see you, bro. Son's Winning is a Horror Story. Exorcism of Emily Rose scares me good.
Oh, my God. Before we get into any of that, like, give your thoughts on that.
Jeepers Creepers. All right, the first one's the best one. The second one was good. That's the one with the school bus, right? With the
studio. It's the second one.
First one's the one where he steals his eyes at the end and he puts on the face.
I didn't mind the first one.
The first one's the best one, right? Do we agree, chat? The first Jeepers Creepers is the best Jeepers Creepers, right?
Mm-hmm.
But this last one, again, what was it called? I forgot the name of it.
Reborn.
Guys, if you watch that movie, you're gonna laugh because it looks like they freaking. It looks like they recorded it with a green screen.
Yeah. I was like, who the hell filmed this? I was like, I think we could have done a better job than this.
Yeah, that was a horrible, horrible movie, period. I can't even say horror. I just say horrible movie.
Horrible movie.
Budget. I would rate it a 3 out of 10.
Not even a 3. I give that like a 1. A 1 is that bad?
I mean, 3, 1.
Let's be honest. We kind of made fun of it while we were watching it.
Yeah.
Like, what the heck is this?
Yeah. But
and
what
then
is...
at some point, I think we were kind of falling asleep.
Yeah.
And then it's just, you know what? Let's just stick through it. Let's finish watching it.
Yeah. And Katrina's onto something. We're going to talk about this a little bit later. So just stay tuned for that. But yeah, Jeepers Creepers 1 and 2 are good. He said my favorite. Then Freddy versus Jason. Freddy versus Jason is pretty good. It's a little outdated if you try to rewatch it.
I've never seen those movies.
You've never seen it?
No.
Wow. That was good. I like the Freddy Krueger movies better. I don't find Jason scary at all.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, he's more like cool factor for him.
Would you say you kind of Jeepers Creepers it scares you?
Jeepers Creepers doesn't scare me. Nothing really scares me, but I like to see like the kills and stuff. Like, you know what I'm saying? Because like they usually put a bunch of dirt bags in these movies, right? So they'll put these dirt bags on, and pretty much like. They don't scare you, but what ends up happening is you root for those dudes to die, like in fun ways. You know what I mean? Like, let me give you an example. Like the last Jeepers Creepers movie we saw, it had old people in it, and thankfully it didn't show them dying or nothing, right? But like those are the people you root for, like sweet old people or innocent kids. Yeah. When they put those jocks, like those dirt bags that just want to have sex all the time,
yeah,
it's like you want them to die. It's like, okay, cut his head off, Freddy, cut his head off. You know, but he said the Conjuring part 1 and part 2 was scary. The Conjuring was scary. Anything that has to do with kids is kind of creepy.
I think you also liked Insidious, didn't you?
Insidious is a classic. I mean, it's not really scary, but it's a classic. Like anything with clowns kind of scares me. That's why I like the clown.
It was a clown?
Yeah. Really? It was a clown. One in the nightmare. Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. True.
I like the It movies.
The It movies are good. The first one, the old one, the old school one, it just has like an eerie 90s vibe to it.
Mm-hmm.
I think the old It movie was scary. The new one is kind of cool, like the graphics and stuff. But that clown, there's nothing creepy about him for me.
Mm-hmm.
Did he creep you out?
No.
There was something about that new it that just wasn't
just scary. The storytelling was pretty good.
The storytelling was great, but he wasn't creepy. Like his head was too big or something. I don't know.
Something about the movies from the back then. I don't know. It was always for some reason a lot more scarier.
Yep. Ozzy said we could have done a better job if we would have put costumes on and started acting. Yeah. It would be better than Jeepers Creepers. Yep. Bro, Ozzy, you seen the movie, bro. That shit is garbage. Oh my god.
Yep.
That is definitely I mean how could they even take such a classic franchise and like go backwards? Usually a franchise like that, you know, it gets better as it goes, right? Mm-hmm. But this was like one of those things that you would think that's the first one in the series and then the first ones are the last ones, right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Nun 2 was trash. I haven't seen none of never the Nun movies. Those.
Yeah.
Never seen them. Krampus?
Ooh. Oh, Krampus. I liked it.
It was more like a thriller than a scary movie. I kind of put it in the same category as that Quiet Place.
Quiet Place? I like the Quiet Place.
Quiet Place is a great like thriller movie, right? Like these motherfuckers stepping on glass and shit. You're like, ah, shit, don't do that. You're gonna get hurt and cut or whatever. Mm-hmm. But it's not like scary. You know what I'm saying? Like for me, no movie that's PG-13 is truly scary. Mm-hmm. For a movie to be scary, it has to be rated R and it has to just grip you. Like, whoa, like you really have to root for the characters. I think the storytelling really factors into that, right?
Mm-hmm. Justin, he disagrees. He says Nun 2 was great.
Wait, Justin said what? Nun 2 was great, really? What was great? I haven't seen any of it, but I mean, to each his own, right? If chat, if you guys have seen the Nun 2, thumbs up or thumbs down? We want to know.
Imaginary was weird, but good for new scary movies. I've heard about Imaginary.
Imaginary, what is that about? He said Thanksgiving in Netflix is kind of weird. Not sure if it's good or what.
Oh, we did watch it.
That's the one with the guy with the V for Vendetta mask.
I think so. Yeah.
There's one scene in that movie that's kind of just like, again, there's some movies that I consider kind of grotesque and not really scary. More mm-hmm. like when they show the body parts and stuff being chopped up.
Saw
turns my stomach every time.
I mean, you don't hate it in the sense that it's not it's bad, but it's more of like you can't.
I like watching Saw.
It's kind of.
But I don't eat nothing when I watch Saw. It turns my stomach bad. I got a weak stomach for like guts and shit. You know? I was like, it grosses me out. But let's see. He said, Dan, what about the Purge movies? Again, I put those under the same categories like thrillers. If you are rooting for the characters, which I rarely am, like it takes a lot for me to like a character. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, usually there's a bunch of, like, in scary movies, they put a bunch of dirtbags on there. It's easy to root for them. I think the director does it on purpose.
Yeah.
Because the director doesn't want you to be pissed that you're killing off his favorite character. He wants you to kind of enjoy the process of, like, or, like, put you in that situation. Like, what would I have done different than this dummy? You know what I'm saying? Like, usually they run in towards the chainsaws and shit. Like, you know what I mean? So that's what I think the directors are doing, really, when they put those dummy characters out there. Like, they don't want you to feel for them. They want you more, like, to put yourself in their shoes. Like, oh, I would have did this. I would have did that better. You know, stuff like that. A good scary movie has characters you care for and some creepy situations that it puts those characters in. And you're, like, really hoping and wishing they don't die. Now, that's a scary movie. I'll tell you. The one we saw, what is it called? The one there in the woods. Blair Witch.
See, it was good up until the ending.
Yeah.
I didn't like the ending.
But there's this part in Blair Witch. I don't know if you guys seen it or not, but if you haven't, close your ears now because spoiler alert. All right. There's this part.
When they're in their tents.
The latest Blair Witch. I don't remember what it's called. It's late at night. And
they hear noises outside the tents.
Yeah, and they come outside and there's like a bunch of crosses hanging from the woods.
Like
and stuff.
Sticks that were tied up.
And crosses. This dude like breaks one and one of his friends like just
snapped.
He snapped in half.
Yeah.
Like that shit creeped me out because it was just like super realistic. Like it was weird. Yeah. And here's the creepy part. We were in the theater all by ourselves, right?
Yes.
It was a ghetto ass theater. It was late at night. We're in the theater by ourselves. And by the way, we're going to do some scary stories, so maybe this counts as a part of it.
Okay,
So there's going to be, again, this is going to be an episode where we, you know, tell you guys a little bit of
everything. Our first movie that I guess you could say.
That scared us. Yeah, popped the cherry. And also, we're going to tell a couple of folk tales, you know, some Mexican urban legends and stuff like that. And if you guys want to share anything, we will read it in the chat. But yeah, it's going to be a little creepy. So hopefully you guys are into that stuff because you guys did vote for it after all. So we'll see what happens. Hopefully you guys have an easy time sleeping tonight. But all right, let's kick it off with
what was the first horror movie you've ever seen that, like, I'm talking about you lost sleep, you had nightmares for days and you couldn't, you know, the one movie that, like, first, like,
all right, y'all gonna laugh at me for this one, but I was about, what, 7 years old when I seen it, my first scary movie, and it was I actually loved this scary movie. It didn't scare me. It was Sleepy Hollow, but I loved it. I love that movie. You know, the Headless Horseman.
It didn't scare you?
It didn't scare me.
No, but I'm talking about
the first one that did scare me. Y'all gonna laugh at
like
me.
Like that you couldn't sleep for days.
It was a hood movie, y'all.
A hood movie?
Yeah, it was Jimmy Bones featuring Snoop Dogg.
Oh my gosh.
Yo, I'm telling you, I was only 7 years old, fam. And I see this movie about the devil, right? And like a haunted mansion or whatever. So of course my imagination ran with me and I was having trouble sleeping. But y'all look it up now and y'all probably gonna laugh. Jimmy Bones was the movie that scared the crap out of me when I was when I was little, bro. But I mean, it's only because it's, you know what I'm saying, like, it kind of, like, it's one of those things that it's like the first, I don't know how to explain it, like, Sleepy Hollow didn't scare me because it took place in, like, in the old hundreds and
you
it's
can't
like
relate.
You can't relate, but a movie about the hood and the devil living in a mansion. I used to know many big houses that were abandoned in Compton, and so my imagination just opened up with that one. But yeah, that was the one. What about you guys, Chet? And what about you, babe?
The first one ever. See, I have two, but the first one I've ever seen, yeah, I was probably like 7 years old.
Yeah.
Was my dad rented out a movie called The Ring, the first one, right?
Ooh, The Ring.
Now that one, now I can watch it easily, right?
Yeah.
But I watched it and for days, I'm talking for days, I had nightmares. Because all I can remember was the, when you pick up the phone, it's 7 days,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
And then... Yeah. You know, yeah, the girl crawling out the well, and then she like kills you after the seventh day.
Yeah,
it's like,
yeah.
I don't know.
That was a good movie though. That's a good movie. See, the one that I had was a stupid movie. Jimmy Bones, Snoop Dogg taking.
See, that was the first one, but the second one that I've seen, and that one really freaked me out.
Uh-huh.
Because you know I do believe in, you know, like demons and ghosts, right, and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Was The Exorcism.
That one's creepy.
And that one, because, you know, it was based on a true story.
Now those are truly scary.
And it showed
movies.
Real pictures of the girl in the end of the movie.
Mm-hmm.
How she looked.
And so I'm gonna be reading. I'm gonna be, keep commenting, guys. I haven't forgot about reading your comments. I'm gonna go back up, scroll up, and I'll be posting your comments right here on the screen. Let's see. My guy said, Final Destination movies are like suspense thriller than horror, just like Purge. Yes. There's a suspense thriller, but there was one Final Destination movie that actually gave me nightmares. I think it was part two.
Gave me nightmares?
Yeah, it just did, because I kept dreaming about, like, dying. It's weird. So yeah, so that was the one.
Constant repeat.
Of, yeah, it's weird.
In many
it's,
different ways.
Mm-hmm. Misery scared me, but I watch
Misery.
Oh! You root for the writer to get away.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, such an old movie. Yeah, I remember that one.
Yeah,
the one where she found the author, right?
You know who used to scare the shit out of me? Uh-huh. Jabba the Hutt, man. When I was a little kid, I used to watch the original Star Wars movies.
Yeah, dude.
That one part when he's like licking his lips and he's about to eat the stripper chick or whatever, bro, that shit tripped me out. Like, that creeped me out. That was more like, yeah, I would always fast forward because I used to have the VHS movie,
yeah,
and I was fast forwarding that part. I didn't like to see that fat motherfucker eat that girl, bro. That shit used to piss me off. He's like, Jabba. I hated that shit, bro. That shit used to piss me off. Christopher says, you and your girlfriend should play The Quarry.
We
played it.
It's a story horror game. It's pretty much a movie. You know what? We did try playing it.
We played it. We went far, but we got stuck in this one part. Remember?
Yeah, and I think we just stopped.
Yeah. Cabin in the Woods. Cabin in the Woods, I liked, because I just feel like there's some realism to that shit. I do feel like the government does experiments and has shit that we don't know about.
The woods are scary.
The woods are scary, though. A lot of shit. Y'all heard what Ryan Garcia has been talking about, the woods.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So there's a lot of weird shit. Oh, should we tell them?
What?
The time we went camping.
What?
When we were sleeping and we heard a bear outside of our tent.
Remember? Oh my gosh, it's just a bear. I thought you were gonna
but
horse.
That's a horror story in itself, fam. Listen, I was shitting bricks.
Now you're just changing the topic.
No, but I will go back to the horror movies.
Okay, go
but
ahead.
This, yo, we was camping, right? It was me and my girl and my mom sleeping in the same tent, right?
Oh no, but tell them why it was also like
epic. Okay, all right. So I told my girl, this was
I
her first
myself
time
for this. Yes, Danny warned me and he told me
this was her first time camping, fam. And I told her, whatever you do, because she usually has like
her, I have dry skin, right?
Okay,
and so I like to apply some sort of oil on my skin, And
before she goes to sleep.
So I apply some avocado oil, right? Want something that have this for the face, right? And Danny was like,
don't,
he's like, don't apply any on your face because you know there's bears here.
And,
I was
and
like,
they can smell it.
And I put it on way earlier.
They like can smell, listen, a bear scent is like, it's, I don't know the exact amount, but it's like 100 times a dog.
Your guys' lives were on my hands.
So like they can smell it from miles away. And so sure enough, right, we're in the tent and it's late. I'm already asleep.
Dude, I was knocked out.
All of a sudden, I hear some heavy creaking in the woods. Yeah, sticks, yeah. You said, crunching right? of the sticks. Like, you know, that sound that bears make mm-hmm. when they, you know, they're nearby. And this motherfucker was sniffing our tent. Like,
right outside, right?
Like that. You could just clearly hear him. You know? And I'm like, my mom, my girl and my mom are asleep. Yeah. And I'm like, hell no, I ain't gonna about to die, bro. I had a machete right there by the tent. And I grabbed the machete. And
no, you
I woke up first. I woke up my girl. I shook
you
her.
You said, I'm not about to go through this alone.
So I'm not going through this shit alone.
You woke up your mom and yeah. me. I was sound asleep. I didn't even hear the bear. And Danny, he shook me. He's like, Sandy. I was like, oh, don't get scared. Don't say, don't yell or anything. I'm like, what? He's like, there's a bear. Oh my God, I started trembling. Yeah. I couldn't stop
she was
shaking
like crazy. I regretted waking her up after that. But I was scared too, fam. I really thought we wasn't going to see the light of day. And then, like, I was ready to strike this mother. I was like, okay, well, I'm going to strike him in the face if he pops his head in here. And then, you know what I'm saying? We're going to go out though, because the tents have like different doors you can zip out of, right? I was like, I'm going to strike him in the face and then we're going to go out that way. If he comes in, I was ready, but I'm not going to lie. That was probably one of the most scary things I ever did mm-hmm. in my life. And, thankfully, the bear went away.
It did, but you know what? He went over to the next like lot, like where they.
He probably killed the neighbors.
Do you remember the guy was sleeping in like a hammock?
Uh-huh.
He didn't even take a tent. He was sleeping on a hammock.
Yeah.
This guy, we heard him. He yeah. turned on his flashlight. He packed up his stuff. He started slamming his car door, the doors to his car, slamming, yep. and then he turned on his car.
We knew the bear was probably coming after him, so he left. He left quick. He booked it. I'm like, how the fuck you sleep in a hammock in the cold, man? But you know, crazy people out there.
Yeah.
But yeah, man, that was probably a meany little horror story, but it was scary. I'm
I
not
felt
gonna
bad
lie.
After because I was like, damn. The moment I heard that bear. Everything was like running through my head, like the fact that you told me do not put anything on your face.
She didn't listen to me, man.
And I'm
she
like, never no, does. Babe. I was like, it's okay, it's too early, you know. And I started like in my head, I was like, oh my God, it's gonna be my fault.
But you learned your lesson, right? Like, don't ever put scented shit in your face. The bears, they can smell it. They smell it for. Listen, the reason every time you go camping, you lock up your food, you got to put it behind a metal crate, is because they would smell it if it was in your car, and they'll destroy your car just to get to the food. So imagine. Imagine my girl having coconut cream on her face and shit.
It wasn't coconut.
Or what was it?
It wasn't. I said it was avocado oil.
Avocado oil.
But it's not like a strong scent as a coconut.
If it would have been the coconut one, guys, we wouldn't be here right now. Yo, my guy said Children of the Corn. Oh, that's a good movie. Children of the Corn is.
I know Danny said about Hills Have Eyes.
Oh, that is a cult classic because it was based on real life, even though they exaggerated for the Hollywood version.
Yeah.
But. Hills Have Eyes is, I think, it's a really good horror movie, y'all.
The fact that it was like,
yeah,
like there's some truth to that.
Uh-huh.
That's what makes it scary. Like,
yeah, and just I mean, the fact that you actually care about these characters, like these weren't mm-hmm. airheads, yo.
Yeah.
I like it when a movie. So yeah, I will put that under horror, but also like on the edge, right? Halloween 1, I don't remember that movie. Children of the Corn was good. Halloween 1, I don't remember. I love Sleepy Hollow 2, bro. The original Evil Dead was scary for me. I like the new one. I wouldn't consider it scary, but it has some jump scare moments, you know? Jump scare. Ichabod Crane. I don't even know what that is, bro, to be honest. You're right on time, Anthony. We talking horror movies, horror stories, and whatever horror in between. If you guys have any for us, I'd love to read them.
Oh, yeah.
Tell us your scary personal encounters. If y'all have paranormal stories, those will be golden.
And
right,
we're gonna
now
put it on the screen and read it aloud and yep. react to it.
That'd be great.
The girl from The Exorcist gave me nightmares, fam. Yeah. Danny doesn't, he doesn't get into those. I'm not saying it's a movie to get into, but like he does not like.
I don't like anything. I don't like anything that has to do with like when they speak in tongues and shit. You know what I mean? Because I've had a like, all right. So I've had a life full of like no bad experience versus my family, my older brothers and my mom. They tell me stories all the time. They used to scare me since I was little, man. Like who here knows about La Mano Peluda, which is the hairy hand that pulls you under the bed. The urban legends
from Mexico.
It's an urban Mexican legend, and they used to tell me like, oh.
Or is it from Mexico? I think they said it was like.
They used to tell me that when you're bad as a little kid, right, mm-hmm. that thing pulls you from your legs and pulls you under the bed and kills you, right? So that was like a thing they used to tell you to scare the crap out of you.
The parents that would tell the stories to the kids.
But my mom actually, like, my brothers have stories of them, like, getting knocked off the bed. Like, it's mm-hmm. like it has some legitimacy to it in Mexico. So, mm-hmm. You know, if you guys have any stories like that, we'd love to read them. Let's see. My guy says, zombie movies are still the best, in my opinion.
Ooh, I love zombie
movies.
She's
a big fan of zombie movies.
But too bad there's not a lot of good ones.
She said, I'm putting them on top tier. Dawn of the Dead. World War Z, Train to Busan was amazing. 28 days later.
Hey, what's that show that we got into that was Korean? Zombie.
I don't know what it's called. I don't remember what it's called.
Dead Alive.
Always something?
No, I'm going to look it up right now because it's such a great show.
My man said, Children of the Corn got me as a child. I feel like anything with kids in it is always creepy, though. Army of the Dead, too old, and I was still a child back then. We'll dream about it often. Yeah, that's... For sure. But is there anything really scarier than The Exorcist? I challenge anybody to bring up something scarier than The Exorcist for sure.
All of Us Are Dead. Korean show. You got to get into that.
Yeah, if you like zombies, bro, watch All of Us Are Dead. It's amazing. It's on Netflix too, right?
It's Korean, but you can switch it, right?
Yeah.
Not subtitles. The other one. What's it called?
Yeah, you can switch it. You can switch it. You could English dubbed.
Yeah, English dubbed.
My guy said, this ain't a movie, but the butterfly episode from SpongeBob freaked me out back then. Yo, when I was a kid, there was an episode from Magic School Bus that used to trip me out. And it was one when they went to a haunted house. Like, that shit scared me. I don't know if it was the little music or whatever, but that shit was scary for sure.
SpongeBob?
No, from Magic School Bus.
Magic School Bus?
There's something about 90s cartoons that's kind of creepy sometimes.
Yeah.
But yeah, the bear.
You know what used to creep me out as a kid? And I remember I told you one time, you're like, what? The Carl Jr. star?
Yeah.
Do you remember the star?
Yeah, the Carl Jr. star.
That used to freak me out.
The Carl Jr. star is winking at people like a pedophile.
I don't know. For me, I felt like it was like a pervert or something. Like every time my mom, like we were be passing by it, like
little girls
freeway,
felt like he was like a visually eye.
No, at least for me.
He said, "Who else ready for the DTLF Cocaine Bear watch along?" That's a great movie, by the way. We love that movie. That shit had us rolling at the movies.
We actually have our own cocaine bear over here.
Oh, yeah. We have a cocaine bear, man. My dog is a cocaine bear. Every time we pull out food, he just eat.
He needs to stick his nose in everything.
And everything, bro. You cannot leave anything.
I don't know if it's a Doberman thing, but man.
Yeah. They're super nosy. He said, my mom was like, Jalen, if you're bad, I'm making you watch Children of the Corn and you talking about having fear.
Yeah. That's funny.
Horror movies back in the day was actually scary. Now scary movies are not as scary.
Yes.
Big facts. You know why? True. Because with the internet now, we see so many things that kind of desensitize you, right? Mm-hmm. And so when you see a scary movie, it's like, I've seen worse than this on the internet, on like a YouTube video or something. Versus back then, bruh, a horror movie would open up your imagination because you ain't never seen nothing like it.
No, but it's not just that.
It feels redundant now.
It's not that great. And then it just feels too fake, you know? Like, I don't know. Something about real stories is just a lot more scary. For me, at least.
Yeah. Madam Web was so horrifying. Is that like a superhero movie?
No.
The original horror movies nobody could touch. Yeah, bro. Because again, it was opening up our imagination. We hadn't seen no shit like that before. Mm-hmm. I remember the first time I saw It the Clown, I was in elementary school. It was during Halloween. I was like in fourth grade. And my teacher wanted to show us that movie. And I was like, we didn't even finish watching it. And I was like, I couldn't wait to go home and rent it and finish it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It was that good. But yeah. The Haunting in Connecticut. I haven't seen that one yet. Is that good?
I don't know. I've heard of it.
Huh? You guys are putting on to some of them, and the one where she does this on the roof.
Oh, right? Hereditary.
Hereditary. That shit creepy, dog.
Yeah, it's a little bit creepy, I guess.
And the other one too. The other one from the same makers. The one where they're like in the middle of nowhere. What is it called?
More details, because I don't know.
The guy that jumps off the
ledge. Oh, Midsommar.
Midsommar, man, that one in Hereditary.
Those were like kind of like Midsommar was more of a like.
But
a
they're creepy. But they're creepy. Like, they're creepy. They're creepy though.
You like.
They're creepy because look, there's real occults out there that do stupid satanic rituals and shit.
Yeah.
And so those movies, they kind of put you in the forefront of that. Mm-hmm. And it creeps you out because of it. Like that. Anything that has to do with
feeling weird afterwards.
Eerie, huh?
Yeah.
Like, you got to pray or something just to get the demons off of you or something. But but yeah, like, movies like that that have to do with reality are, like, they kind of creep me out, but for mm-hmm. sure.
Deep Prince. Ooh, yeah. Hills Have Eyes. Man, one of my favorites. Also, Wrong Turn. Wrong Turn.
Yeah, Wrong Turn's good. The first Wrong Turn was great.
One and two only. The rest are exaggerated.
Yeah, the first one was amazing. Mm-hmm. The original Texas Chainsaw Massacre. I mean, the fact that it's based on a true story is a amazing. Killer Clowns. I haven't seen it. What's up, Alan? How you doing, bro?
What up?
I would say I don't fuck with movies
like
that.
No, we don't watch that.
Anything like that, I ain't fucking with it. If it's too, like you can literally go get a Ouija board and do it, I'm not fucking with it. I'm just not.
Yeah.
No. Friday the 13th, part 3. That was in 3D. Friday the 13th, part 3. I don't remember it, all of them, because I was a kid when I seen a lot of these. But Night of the Living Dead. The Walking Dead. Isn't that a show?
Yeah, it is.
We're crossing over now. Are we fans of The Shining? I definitely like the second Shining. One. The second one. The original one was good too, but the second one, the one with the little kids, what was it called?
Shining 2. I don't know.
It was called something else. But the one with the.
I can look it up if you want.
Ewan McGregor?
Let me see.
Oh, dude, that movie was awesome.
Part 2.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. We got a story by Dante, too. By the way, Dante, we was able
I did watch the movie, Scarface.
Yeah, she saw Scarface. She liked it,
bro.
It was
a great movie.
Yep. So thank you for the super chat last time, bro. We appreciate you.
Yeah.
Or the cash up, I think it was. Mm-hmm. All right, here's a story by Dante. I was playing hide and seek in a room, and the box was moving and shaking crazy. Then I ran out and said, "What is that?" The moms come laughing. Okay. They had a live turkey that was going to slay. Oh my God. Let me tell you something, bro. The creepiest part of your story is that the moms were going to slay a turkey, bro.
The moms.
like, what the? Damn, savages, man. They were about to slay it themselves. They weren't even going to have the guys do it. Yeah. That's crazy. That was alive. Hellraiser. Insidious is good. It's a classic. I like classic movies. my dog snoring. Yeah.
Snoring in bed.
Are you guys fans? Yeah, The Shining was great. The second one was my favorite, though. The new one with Ewan McGregor. Yep. Goosebumps. I remember those books as a kid, and I remember the show that used to come out.
I love watching that.
Yeah.
Let's see. Especially around Halloween. Yeah.
Let's see. My guy, and I'll go back up. But my guy said, "All right, Danny, Yesi, I'm heading to sleep. Good night." All right, bro.
Not yet. No, just kidding.
Don't have any nightmares now. Thank you for super chat, brother. Appreciate you. Let's see.
Have a good night.
Texas. Mm-hmm. He said Russell Westbrook on the Lakers was scary. I almost died.
Oh, whoa.
What's the movie Dan and Lady in White Who Was Killing Everyone?
The Lady in White Who Was Killing Everyone? La Llorona. I'm just kidding.
La Llorona? You talking about La Llorona?
I don't know. The Lady in White?
Talking about La Llorona, I got a creepy story myself, y'all, that I'm about to drop on you guys about La Llorona, right? Because obviously, La Llorona is a Mexican folktale that parents tell us about this lady,
Do you want me to give you a brief description?
She can give you the more real. I was going to give them the rundown of the quick story.
Yeah, you want to?
So pretty much it was a lady that drowned her kids in the river.
No, it's because it says...
all right, go ahead. Read it.
La Llorona is a tale of tragic love and eternal regret. Betrayed by the man she loved in a fit of rage and despair, she drowned her children and then took her own life. Now her spirit is forever trapped between the world of living and the dead, wandering near bodies of water, her mournful cries echoing in the night. Legends warns that those who hear her lamentations should not approach, for she might just mistake you for one of her lost children.
Y'all heard that? All right. Well, I got a real life story. I put this on everything, and I told this one to my parents. I told this one to my girl, right? You know this story, right?
Mm-hmm.
I actually went to go visit Mexico when I was a kid, right? When I was about 9 years old, maybe 10. Don't remember the exact age. Well, my grandma, you know, was getting older and she was getting sick. So my mom would visit her often, you know, in Guadalajara, which is in the center of Mexico, in the heart of Mexico. Mm-hmm. And over there, it was a small town, dirt roads. You know, they had these old classic churches, right? I'm talking like straight out of a horror movie. Like these are poor little churches, but they're classic, right? They look beautiful and during the day, but during the night, whew. And one day, my mom sent me and my little cousins out to the market. And now, mind you, Mexico has a lot of little side roads and stuff. So the market was kind of like a cool block away. However, there was a couple turns my cousins took to try to get me lost. And sure enough, they did. They ran away from me. They were older than me, my cousins. They ran away from me thinking it was funny. So your boy got lost, man, as a kid in Mexico. So here I am trying to find my way back, trying to retrace my steps. And like two hours pass. Nothing. I think I got deeper lost in the town.
Nobody went looking for you?
My brother did, but I was in different streets by then. Uh-huh. So what I did, see, being an intelligent kid, I tried to retrace my steps back like the way I came. And hoping that, you know, somebody had come looking for me. Well, before that happened, I was passing an old church. It was an old, beat down, wore down church. And the sun was starting to set. So it was really dark now. Like, the sun was behind the church already. So it was starting to get dark. And Mexico is really dark. Mm-hmm. When it rains a lot. And when it gets really dark. And you start hearing the crickets and the animals get louder because you're in the, like, a small desert town. Mm-hmm. And sure enough, I was alone in this street. The sun had already set as I'm walking back, retracing my steps.
You say you were passing by a church.
I'm passing by a church when I see this cloaked up lady all in black. I kid you not.
By the church?
By the church. Well,
in front?
Well, okay. So before I pass the church, I see her up ahead. And she's the only one on the street. It's a narrow street, mind
you.
And
it was at night.
It was at night. It was already like 7 o'clock. And you know, the sun takes a little bit longer to go down. But once it goes down, it gets dark. Mm-hmm. And all you see is like the flickering street lights. And literally like a horror movie. So in order for me to get back home, I got to get past this lady who's walking really slow. And it sounded like she was saying something, maybe crying, maybe making a sound effect. Mumbling, yes. And there's a lot of poor people in Mexico, so it could have been anything, right? But
she's on crack.
I kid you not. I walk past this lady slowly and she turns and she looks at me. And when I look, you couldn't see its face. It was like all dark, like literally dark, maybe because it was nighttime for whatever.
It was death.
Bruh.
Looking at you.
Like, y'all know what they believe in, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm thinking, oh shit, I heard this story before. You know what I'm saying? Like I heard this one. And I booked it. I start running. And I look back and I kid you not.
What?
This thing was coming after me. It was literally moving, but like, not too fast. Yeah. Like in a mid pace. Like it sped up.
Yeah.
Bruh. My heart jumped out of my stomach. I remember the shivers, like I felt.
Was she like gliding or was it like?
No, I didn't look. Walking? I was running. She didn't stop to look at the details. I was trying to live to tell the story, you know? Yeah. So I booked it and my fear actually made me retrace all my steps back. And then my brother was there at the market where they had left me. That's so I got back home. But yo, that was probably the scariest story. So
you're
telling
me you wouldn't have been here right now?
I don't know. Shit. If it was like Yorona, if it was that lady, I probably would have, I don't know. I would have been one of them dead river kids or something.
I don't know if you've seen, there's some videos on YouTube. There was this guy in Mexico too. I don't know which part of Mexico.
Yeah.
That it's late at night as well. Uh-huh. And that part where you say it gets really dark.
Yeah.
I understand. Like, I get it. Because in that video, the man, you can hear the fear in his voice. Like, he's in his truck. It like, I think he had just gotten back from work or he was about to leave.
Yeah.
I don't know exactly, but he was in his car parked on the side and he starts recording and you can hear in his voice where he's like, and in Spanish, of course, he's like, oh my God, do you hear her? She's coming. She's getting closer. Right.
Yeah.
And you can hear like literally the weeping her. And he was saying, it's like Llorona, La Llorona. He starts yelling. He's like, it's La Llorona. And you can hear her in the back, like getting closer and closer. And oh my God, that video, it kind of did scare me because I was like, damn, is La Llorona real? Like, that's scary. Like, the guy, like, I'm talking about, this man was an older ass man, like, and he was scared.
Bruh, that is creepy. I'm telling y'all,
and
man.
Search it up on YouTube.
Listen,
look,
listen.
The guy that's in his truck.
I've never had a paranormal experience, but I do believe that was the closest thing to paranormal I've ever experienced. It was late at night. I'm walking by an old beat down church. This. Oh, why would you wear all black and why would you have a cloak over your face
at night,
like the Grim Reaper, right? Mm-hmm. And it was kind of tall for a Mexican.
And the streets were like very quiet. There's nobody.
Babe, there was flickering lights at the end of the street. Mm-hmm. It's a small town, and it's like, holy shit, bro! What did I get myself into? I thought. I instantly remembered all the folk tales and all the stories my mom used to tell me as a kid. That shit was scary. And you're right, KJ. You're right. The Yorona scary was not, the Yorona movie wasn't scary. That's why I was pissed off, because I actually experienced something like that.
It doesn't do it justice.
And it didn't do it justice to the actual folktale. Yep. As Above, So Below is a good movie. I like that movie.
Yeah.
That's a good one, Robert.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. That is a great one.
Absolutely. But the ending too, I think I wasn't a fan of the ending. But
yeah.
I did like the movie. Good story.
Is it Dan, read the book? Amityville Horror? Is it good like that? The book or the show or the movie? Like, what's better? Dodgers win, beat the Giants. Hey, let's go Dodgers. I'm still sad they didn't win in my presence, but I'm happy for the Dodgers. Mm-hmm. My guy said, yeah, my boy was African, and they said it was tradition for Thanksgiving to slay and cook the turkey. Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, that's normal there. We're just not used to women slaying anything over here.
I know.
My favorite part of The Exorcist is when the little girl is going down the staircase upside. Nah, bro.
That's your favorite part?
Oh, nah, bro. That and her throwing up the pea soup and all that. Ugh, all that is disgusting.
Mm-hmm.
He said, you need to play the Ouija board then?
Are
I'm good, bro. My life is full of peace right now. No. Alfonso trying to get me killed, though. No. He's trying to have that Llorona come back for me, though. Mm-hmm. I'm good. My biggest nightmare. Appreciate you, Isaiah. Thank you, bro. Hey, appreciate you. Hey, game recognized game, bro. Ooh, respect, brother.
Look at that.
Let's see. Tengo miedo, he said.
Tengo miedo.
Bro, it is, if y'all heard some of the stories I didn't hear from my uncles.
Oh, my God.
And some of the stories I didn't heard from my, maybe we might have to save this for
Mexicans,
another episode.
But
Mexicans
older generations, they have stories.
Because they live in small towns, and sometimes Mexicans mess with a lot of that witchcraft bullshit.
My mom had a lot of stories, and I believe it because, you know, I did have a few encounters
with
certain things, and, you know.
Yeah.
It's something that you have to experience yourself to believe it.
And a lot of people don't believe, but the truth of the matter is when you go through something, it's creepy. Like, and it changes everything, man. He said, I still watch Goosebumps. I haven't seen it in a cool minute.
I love Goosebumps.
Uh-huh. Dan, do you consider the Blade movies horror, the original Wesley Snipes? No, but I love them. Mm-hmm. I consider that action and gore.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I know they put it in the horror genre because there's blood and stuff like that. But it's more cool than actually creepy. Like I said, for me, horror has to be like on the edge, suspenseful and scary, and you rooting for the characters. And then creepy shit happens, right? The one I do like a lot. The recent one we saw in the theater, that was one of my favorite horror movies probably in the last 10 years.
Horror movie?
The one with the handshake.
Oh, Talk to Me.
Talk to Me, fam.
Talk to Me.
If y'all haven't seen Talk to Me,
that was pretty good.
Good storytelling.
It didn't scare me, but yeah, it was a good movie.
Good storytelling. Yeah. It scared me in the moment. Nothing like, I'm grown, so nothing gives me nightmares.
No nightmares.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He said, Llorona. Oh my freaking God, have me shaking in my Kobe's.
go on YouTube and look up that video, the one that I'm telling you about the guy that he's recording.
Yeah.
And man, he's petrified. Like, he's on the verge of crying.
Yeah.
Because he hears her getting closer and closer to where he's parked.
Yeah.
And mind you, there's nobody in the streets. It's nighttime, too. So, you know, poor guy.
Facts, man.
Still
a lot of scary stuff, man. A lot of scary stuff. I'm sure a lot of you guys have scary stories. Matter of fact, I think we got one right here by my guy, Ryan.
My mom was a cheerleader with her cousins in 91. They got off practice, walked to the bus stop. The bus never came. They were followed by a guy. They ran to a gas station. They called my grandpa. Oh.
Hey, that's pretty horrific as well, man.
These men. Those type of men, I don't know.
That's pretty horrific as well, man. Too bad you weren't there with the machete to cut their arms off, bro. Like that's tough. That's tough right there.
It's crazy.
Yeah. And your grandpa. Shout out to your grandpa, man.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. He said, no cap. I don't believe you, Dan. That's messed up, bro. I ain't never capped on here, man. That's fucked up. But hey, you're entitled.
To each their own, you know.
Yeah, you're entitled to believe what you want, but. That was the scariest experience I ever had in my life. And it was when I was a kid. So, of course, you wouldn't believe me, but that's okay.
Like you know? I said, you have to experience it yourself.
Yeah.
Go through some sort of experience to believe it.
Mm-hmm. Long time ago.
If anything, he's probably thinking we're crazy. I was like, these two are crazy.
No, I mean, that was the most like paranormal like experience I had. If it even was that, it could have just been a regular ass old lady. But why was she
chasing
me? Past
midnight at night? Just standing
there? It wasn't midnight. The sun was just setting.
Had to set.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. The next day, they went to the gas station to thank the worker there. There was no gas station there. Nah, bro.
What?
Trip out.
Something saved them. That's crazy.
Yeah, trip out. Damn, I thought your story was done and it was only starting, man. Appreciate you, Robert. No, it really happened. It's a true story on everything. That's on everything. I got creeped out when I seen that shit.
There's no point of him lying. You know?
No, but look, I'll tell you this. They don't have to believe me. But I still remember the eerie feeling of having to walk past that person to get to my destination. You know what I mean? Like, I was like hesitating as a kid. Can you imagine? Can you imagine, like, as a kid trying to get past something that you might think is a folktale? Like, it was scary, bro. That's all I'm going to say. Is it An American Werewolf in Paris is a classic? That is a classic movie. I like that one. Mm-hmm. I like that one for sure. Yo, girl has a sinister voice.
Oh, what the heck?
She could be a horror narrator.
Like,
that's a compliment.
When, Or when I read the story.
Probably, probably the way you read it and shit. That was funny.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm scared. He said, I'm scared of raccoons. Yeah, let's see. Get Out was good. It was good. I like that movie.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Didn't scare me, but I definitely like the storytelling. I think Jordan Peele is a beast at like storytelling.
I think there's some truth
to that. Mm-hmm. The movie Amityville Horror from 2004. Oh my freaking God. I gotta see it, y'all. Y'all been raving about this one for a minute. 1999 Blair Witch. Love that movie. And a lot of people were speculating if it was true or not.
It's the around older that time. One?
Yeah, the old one.
You've seen it?
Yeah. X-Files, never seen him, bro, to be honest. Mm-hmm. Did ever run turn the light switch off the room because you watched a scary movie? The dark doesn't really scare me, to be honest with you.
I'm gonna be honest,
only when I was a kid, but now as an adult, like the dark.
Honest, man, I'm not scared of it like that, but if I were alone,
yeah
probably.
Yeah.
It's because, you know what, I've had bad experiences,
yeah,
you know. Uh-huh. With the dark, so it's like I don't know.
He said, watch Blaze Booth, bro. Is that a good movie? Is that what genre is it, bro? He said, Talk to Me didn't do it for me.
Talk to Me.
It did it for me, man. It was good storytelling, and
the story was good.
Yeah. The part with the kid, man, that shit tripped me out. The part with the kid freaked me out. Always, like I said, shit with kids always gets me, bro. That's mm-hmm. Those are the parts. Damn, I like Talk to Me, but I don't get the ending though.
She was possessed.
No, she died, bro, in the end.
But wasn't she, like, possessed?
Well, I don't want to give up too much, just in case somebody didn't
Okay, never. I'm sorry. She was not possessed.
Bram Stoker, Dracula. 2003, House of a Thousand Corpse. Dan, do you think Haley Van Lith made a mistake joining Angel Reese instead of Paige Bukers or Caitlin Clark? No, I don't think she made a mistake. I mean, they had a good run. LSU competed in the first half. In the second half, I believe the reason they lost because Angel Reese got hurt. You saw that, right?
Mm-hmm.
She got hurt and she couldn't really. She was killing in the first half. But credit, man. Credit to Caitlin Clark. She's a monster. I mean, she's just 9 3-pointers, fam, in college. That's insane. Latinos always believe ghost stories. It's because, you know what, bro? When you encounter something, it makes you a believer. When you don't encounter something, well, obviously you're not going to believe it, of course. But, you know, Mexicans, this is a problem I have with some, like, older generations of Mexicans. They fuck with a lot of that witchcraft
Brujeria,
shit.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, and that's why they be seeing
and
shit.
And sometimes it's just like a generational curse that, like,
none of that shit. And I think that's why I don't really experience stuff like that in general, you know? And that's why I will never fuck with
none
of
that
shit.
You know, it's not, it's just Mexico, it's like Africa and other
different countries, like third world countries, they tend to experience
they mess with all of that.
Yeah, because, you know, when you live in poverty, you're just gonna get creative, you know, and you're gonna look for different ways to pass the time and cultures and all that, you know. Have you seen Smile? I think we've seen this movie, haven't we?
Yes, we have.
I don't remember if we liked it or not.
I don't know, it's been a while back. So
Alfonso said Mexico does have a lot of ghosts, though, from what I've heard from my mom. Again, it's because they fuck with that crazy shit at every
turn. It's not just that. It doesn't necessarily mean that they're the one messing with
somebody in the area. Shit.
Family members, or it's just like, I guess, a home that's haunted or
look,
something.
My house, I've never seen nothing because I don't fuck with that shit. That's my theory, at least.
Well, I don't know.
Insidious scared me too real. Insidious was good.
Mm-hmm.
No me gustan los duendes.
Oh my God, los duendes. And I was just telling you about that too.
Yeah, she was telling me a story, man.
Well, I don't have a personal story. It's just I had a Spanish teacher in high school that told us a story about los duendes and that he believes that he has seen them. Yeah. But then he also thinks that maybe he ate too much and he was full and that he had gone to sleep. And
people will always cope one way or another. They're like making an excuse for why they didn't see it.
He thinks, because he tells a story that he was asleep, and then on the bottom of the door, like, I guess the light in the hallway shines through under the door, right?
Yeah.
And he said that he saw little, like, footprints? Little feet. No, not footprints. Like, the feet. Like, the shadows, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And they were tiny. And he said he could hear them. Like, they were talking amongst each other. But he also thinks that maybe it was just, like, a, some sort of nightmare that he had. But, like, I don't know.
Yeah. Damn.
It's crazy, though.
That is crazy. That's pretty creepy. And for those that don't know, duendes is like dwarfs. Dwarfs, like Mexican dwarfs. Lost Tapes 1 and 2 are the best ones. I haven't seen them. I don't think I have.
Mm-mm.
Well, or unless that's like a side title to a movie. Sounds familiar, but mm-hmm. Blaze Booth is a horror movie about the second coming of Jesus as a kid. Those good story to me. Oh, mm-hmm. Snap. A horror movie about Jesus? I might just have to check this out.
Coming of
Jesus. Look what Search said.
Demons are real. If you open the door, you regret it. That's right,
Talk Search. To them, Search. Talk to them. People don't believe until it's too late.
Man,
facts.
People just don't believe it.
That's why I don't open the doors. I keep my doors
shut, man.
I'm 100%
believer. I believe in it. And no.
Your mom has stories. My mom has stories. Everybody's mom has stories.
Yep. I experienced it, so I know it's real.
Yep.
Cuba, Haiti. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. A lot of third world countries, man. They mess with
it. Oh, my God.
Candyman in the 90s got me scared of the mirror. I feel you on that. Who remembers the Bloody Mary story they used to tell and they used to attempt?
Oh my God.
In elementary school, they used to close the door. Remember?
That's what I was going to talk about. Yeah. Like in elementary school, that you would turn off the lights, right? You would turn off the lights and you'll say Bloody Mary like 6 times or 3 times. I don't remember how many times because I never done it and I don't want to mess with that.
Yeah.
And that when you flick the lights back on, that you will see her like in the mirror. Like, you know,
people getting creative. Sometimes I think it was made up, but
I don't know. I do
remember my friends trying to close the door on me and shit when I was in the restroom.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I remember that shit when I was a little kid. Yep.
It's crazy because you know what? Back then, like on TV, they will show like, I guess, like real stories of families. that have, I guess, they experience like demons or you know ghosts.
Yeah.
And one of them was a family that had moved into a new home, and this little boy, the little brother, he was afraid of sleeping in his bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
And so his older brother and his older brother and his friends decided like, hey, let's mess with my little brother and lock him in the closet.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, he was afraid of the closet because he said that every night that door will open up and he would just like feel like an evil presence in that closet. And so his older brother and the brother's friends decided like to throw him in the closet and lock the door and left him there like all day. And finally, like, I guess when the mom, you know, asked like, hey, where's your little brother? He decided to go like, you know, to check up on him in the closet. He opened the door and he was gone. Like he had
disappeared. And they never found him.
That's fucked up. Like they called the cops. They arrived and they checked the whole house and he was gone.
That's crazy. Yeah, I've heard stories like that. Like that's creepy, right? That's why I don't fuck with none of that shit. Shit, when I have kids, I'm gonna stay on top of them. They can't even go outside without my. You know what I'm saying? Like there's a certain age that they won't even be able to play outside without me guarding, like you know, because of kidnappings and stuff.
No.
Like me making sure that they're well supervised. Always gonna be on top of them. Damn. Alfonso has a story for us. So go ahead and read it, babe, since you have the creepy voice.
Ooh, damn! I have a story from my mom. When she was young in Mexico, she was having a sleepover with her primas, and she woke up at 3 a.m. and said she saw a red goat-like figure at the edge of the bed. Ooh, that's the devil.
A red goat-like figure?
That's scary.
She saw the Baphomet dog? What the fuck? Yo, what was her friends doing, bro? They was doing some heavy witchcraft.
Wow, but it's Mexico, though, Lenny.
I'm telling you, these girls love fucking with witchcraft.
No, it's not even that. It's just a lot goes on over there.
Don't date no witches.
Yeah, and you don't date no Mexicans in that case.
Nah, that's messed up. Not all of them.
No, I'm just saying because it's a lot of that happens over there, you know?
Yeah. Silent Hill, especially the first one, got me on the edge of my seat in the cinema house. Okay, Silent Hill. I remember that one. Mexicanos believe in El Día de los Muertos.
Mm-hmm.
Day of the Dead, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
My guy said, hell yeah, Candyman and Freddy Krueger and Bloody Mary types, all creepy, fam. All creepy. And by the way, we got 100 in here, man. If y'all want another late night tomorrow, y'all want to keep this vibe going, make sure y'all hit that like button, man. Let's get 100 likes. Let's shoot for 150 because I know there's going to be some people watching this later on. Let's shoot for 150. We'll bring an episode tomorrow. We'll let success be our guide. We get 150 likes in this video. We'll do one tomorrow again. All right, let's keep reading these comments. Dan, do you believe in aliens and UFOs? I don't know about aliens, but we saw UFOs. And again, people are probably not going to believe us. Mm-hmm. But where I live right here, bro, literally, I already said the story when we was going to Amazon late at night to work.
We were going into work at 3. No. 3? It was, no, 12. 3 or 4. Like around 12. Remember 12? We had a clock in.
No, this was when we used to have the later shift, remember? When we used to have the, it was like 3 a.m. or 4 a.m.
Yeah.
And it was like right before the sun came up. Mm-hmm. And
it was the hour that everyone was like
about to go to work, man. And literally this happened outside in the right here in the complex where we live. Right here, it happened.
Yeah.
Two of us we're two witnesses. If you don't want to believe both of us combined, then that's on you. But we looked up, man, there was a flashing light that just zooted away and left the leaves of the trees and everything just shaking like in the movies when a UFO.
That flash was so bright, like it literally like it blinded us for a second. Like we're like, what the heck? And then you just hear that, like
speed of light though. Yeah. It was hovering above the tree where we were passing by. Yeah. And when I looked up, because I felt like something was looking at me, I saw it for a brief second. And if you saw the flash, right?
Saw a flash.
And it zooted away fast as hell, man. Leaving the trees and everything like just
swaying. It was just swaying
back and forth. Uh-huh. So it must have been pretty big. If the tree was swaying like that.
I was like, what the heck? I was like, did you see that? We're like, yeah.
And we told our coworkers that day, and people were like, it must have been a drone. Like, hell no, what no damn
bird
drone.
Or something.
That shit made a weird sound effect, like a spaceship, bro. That shit made a weird sound effect. So, hey, you know, like people never want to believe you, you know, but it was funny, though. It was
the chupacabra.
It didn't do shit to us, so we're good. Chupacabra, I heard that one. Sinister Shudder and the Ring.
You know what? The chupacabra, I don't know how that... how the story goes, like I've heard about it, but it's just
like a goat eater that eats animals.
And it feasts
on their flesh, I think. And it would there's like places like in ranches where whole cows were like slaughtered, like intestines all out and shit, and they call it a chupacabra because people would see it and look weird. Mm-hmm. It looked like a demonic entity but on fours. It's weird.
Did you watch Dorian Gray? No,
not really. I think this guy meant to say if God exists, you know, there has to be bad. Oh, for sure.
Yes.
Yep. True. And amen, Zach. Always have your trust in God. He is our savior. Big facts, mm-hmm. brother. Big facts. That's why I fear, you know, hear no evil. See, what is that they say? See no evil, hear no evil or something like that. I fear no evil, man. Forgot about Bloody Mary. Yeah, bro. Yeah. That was a big thing in elementary school for sure. Yeah.
I'm telling y'all at the sleepover, if the TV freezing, don't go turn it off. Don't do it, y'all. Don't go turn it off. I heard you're supposed to turn it off.
If the TV is freezing, I'm pulling the cord, bro.
I heard you're not supposed to have it on.
That light bill's going to be expensive. If the TV's freezing, I'm probably throwing a rock to that bitch.
I remember there was a movie about that, too.
Yeah.
About, like, television. I don't remember how it goes, but it's been a long, long time ago.
Yeah.
Dan lost tapes. Oh, you didn't even.
My bad.
Dan lost tapes are found footage. They are real scary and good. Lost tapes.
Yeah. That sounds where can you watch that at? Remember the TV show Beyond Belief, the supernatural stories, fact or fiction? I don't remember it.
Yeah, I used to watch that. Yeah. Yep. But it's so long ago that I don't remember all the stories to it. But yes, I used to watch it.
Yeah.
That's creepy.
Hmm. Call is a great horror movie also.
Hmm.
I don't think
we
yeah I don't think I've it. Seen that yeah
yeah it's Mexico way, it's everywhere.
Damn.
Everywhere.
Yeah, Call is a Korean movie though. Oh, we love those. We love watching Korean movies and shows. Yep.
Maybe we can watch it.
Yeah. Let's see, 61 watching on Twitter. Hey, shout out to the Twitter followers. Yeah, I'm multi-streaming for sure. Yeah, we got one on my. We got 91 here and 61 over there. Yeah. He said, man, fuck Amazon. He said, I'm off today chugging this 40. That's right, bro. Enjoy your day off. Hey, listen, I was right there with you, man. You're going to make it out of there. Don't worry about it, brother. You'll be all right.
Amazon. Dan, would you tell your kids scary bedtime stories? No.
Depends. If they're assholes, which they're not going to be, my kids are going to be perfect little soldiers.
I wouldn't. I mean, once they're a little bit older.
If they're jerks, yeah, I'm going to tell them all the same scary stories my mom told me, just so they could chill out.
Oh, no.
Like, I'm going to be like, hey, te va a agarrar la mano peluda, which means...
Later on, they're going to be trying to sleep with us in bed. Our bed.
always have trust in your God and Savior. Prayer works. He does miracles. Big facts.
Yep.
Big facts, Zach. The Ring is the movie with the TV? Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, where that was the first movie.
Where the crackhead is popping out, man, and she's super flexible.
She walks out of the television.
Backwards and shit, yeah. Uh-huh. Yo, Dan, the scariest movie that tripped me the fuck out was The Visit. Watch that one. Mm. Okay.
We're going to have to take notes. The Visit.
Yeah, we're going to have to go back and see what Katrina says. Queen.
Poltergeist is a TV horror movie.
Is it? Is it good?
TV horror movie. I've never seen it. I don't know.
A Stranger's Calling scared me.
A Stranger's
Calling. That sounds like a 90s movie. Is it? Is it Angel? It sounds familiar.
Sleep paralysis. Oh, yes.
Oh, Robert's touching on some horror shit. He says sleep paralysis is like a scary story when you feel like someone is watching you at night and hearing slimy sounds or buzzing sounds or feeling some presence in the corner of your room. You know what this brings me to? The next topic. Mm-hmm. Life after death. Mm-hmm. If you can have a nightmare, right? Mm-hmm. And they say death is like an eternal sleep. Then is it possible that that's what your hell is? Is it an eternal nightmare? You know what I'm saying? And maybe, and I've, here's a theory for you guys. Maybe if you're a good person in life, you go to heaven because your conscience is clean and you think of good things even when you go to sleep. Versus if you're a jerk and you're doing bad shit all the time, your conscience is always bad and so you have nightmares. So if you die while your conscience is dirty, then maybe you'll have an eternal nightmare.
No,
I'm just saying. That's just a concept.
Because I have had nightmares, and that is, you know.
You are bad. No, it's like,
I'm bad.
But I mean, in general, like your conscience is clear versus it not being clear. Like, what could it be, right? No. Mexican moms with the chanclas are scary. Big facts, bro.
Chanclas.
Big facts. Having an out of body experience when you hear. Oh man, I don't think I've ever had one of those.
An out of body experience when you're here.
Yeah, I don't think, man.
No, I never experienced that.
Huh.
I've experienced sleep paralysis.
Yeah.
And that is scary as hell.
No one said The Grudge, Japanese original horror movie. Mm-hmm. There's a Japanese version of that?
Yeah.
Oh man, sign me up. That sounds dope. Alfonso said, love the late night streams, bro. Let's beat Toronto. Appreciate you, bro. And hey, we get 150 likes on this video. We coming right back tomorrow. And maybe tomorrow we can talk about a different topic. I'll let you guys vote on Twitter.
We're coming back right after this episode.
Tomorrow, 150 likes. That's all it takes. We got 109. Start off with that. My guy said, nah, it's 2000s movies where there's someone in the house calling this girl's babysitting. All right, I might have to check that out for sure.
Yeah.
It sounds like Scream, doesn't it? A little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Having an out-of-body experience when you're so tired and hearing the buzz sound louder and louder. I feel like I'm sinking into my bed and flying as a spirit over building and seeing a body bed. Oh.
Whoa, do you experience those?
Robert is releasing all his demons in his stream. My man said he's floating over his own body. He said astral projection. Crazy, bro. Yeah, I would hate to experience that. Thank God I have not experienced that yet. Hopefully I never experience that. I want my conscience to stay inside of my body for sure. He said, I used to dream a lot, but now I barely get them. Shake my head.
Same.
Angel, that's me and you, bro. I close my eyes and then when I open them, I'm awake already. It's the same feeling, bro.
You know what I tell Danny? I always tell you I love dreaming, even if it's nightmares for some reason. It's just like a story, you know?
Yeah.
I love stories, so.
I like that base and car collector. I appreciate you, bro. Yeah, I agree.
Your good deeds don't save, your faith alone does.
He says, sleep paralysis, scary AF. He said, I get it when I sleep on my back.
What?
Bro, better turn around.
Sleep on your side?
Yeah, no, he's sleeping upside down. He's sleeping face down, ass up, man. Nah, bro, I feel you, though. I ain't never experienced that, bro. That's crazy, man. Yeah, that's crazy. He's at a scary time. Yes, sir. Hey, this was a successful episode, man. Again, 150 likes. We come right back tomorrow, and I'll let you guys vote on any topic you guys want, whether it's relationship advice or it's anything. I do to Die Hard scary as hell. What? I didn't get that one.
I do. to Die Hard. Scary as hell.
The Descent.
The Descent. The Descent.
Hey, KJ Nasty said, y'all get the wet dreams? Y'all nasty.
Who gets wet dreams? Mixie?
Oh, I know KJ be dreaming about them cheerleaders, man, them Laker girls. I think
he exposes himself right now.
Bro, be sleeping next to his girl. He'd be sounding off, talking in his sleep, talking about, oh, yeah, baby, yeah, with the pom-poms.
Oh, no.
Is it actually like the Paranormal Activity, the Mark ones? It's the Mexican one? I don't think I've seen any of those movies, bro.
No.
Oh, see, I told you, bro. I told you.
Laker girls. Oh, my gosh. Scared.
Yeah, I have to sleep on the stomach or side for real, for real. Damn, I don't know how you do that. I cannot sleep on my stomach.
You should record yourself one day sleeping on your back.
Oh, hell no.
And watch your...
That shit's going to go viral.
Yeah, why not?
Watch bro start floating for real.
Funny.
They're gonna think he got magnets on the roof or something.
That would be perfect for Dante. Oh, who was it that didn't believe in that? No, what was his name? Some guy that was saying it's not real.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know, man.
It wasn't Dante. Sorry.
I'll read a couple more before we get off. He said, "What y'all know about succubus and incubus? Ooh, are those the ones that look like women, but they're like vampires, and they suck men's soul away? Is that what you're talking about?" I seen those, not in real life, but in like,
I think. Mixtape wants that.
Yeah. Yo, she roasted you. She said you want a succubus, man. She going to suck the soul right out of you, bro. Oh, man.
Laker girls.
Oh, Laker girls. Oh, we got one here. He said, as a child growing up in the Caribbean, sleep paralysis was scary, especially after a funeral. Oh, ooh,
after a funeral. That's crazy. No, those sleep paralysis. Oh, it's no joke. Danny, do you remember when I had one? You were awake when you.
Oh, yeah. Don't even remind me, bro. I was scared of my girl in that moment.
No.
Like, bro.
I was scared.
Bro, I had to shake her till she woke up.
I know we're laughing and all, but it's no jokes. Like, jokes aside, it was. You know, it really happened, you know?
Sleep paralysis. I'm glad I ain't never experienced. I'm with God.
You've
man.
Never experienced?
I ain't never experienced sleep paralysis.
Dude, I think I have experienced at least like four times
in my life. I'm going to pray to God that I don't experience that shit ever, man.
That's scary.
I won't ever go to sleep if that happened to me. Scary. I'm going to be up with my eyeballs open and shit. He said they try to have sex with you. That's exactly what KJ wants, man. He wants a succubus to succubus.
He's looking it up right now.
Bro, Googling that shit like
how to attract the succubus. Yeah.
He heard suck and bus and he put them together like
suck my bus. Hold up.
I'm on to something here.
Oh my god, you're so dumb.
Yo.
Oh my god.
Oh man. Yo, that's crazy, yo. The Innocent 1961, extremely creepy and psychological.
Put it on the screen, baby.
Oh my bad, my bad. I'm so used to reading them like that. The Innocent 1961, extremely creepy and psychological. The scares in the film feel extremely modern. The absolute best version, The Turn of the Screw. Watch at night with the lights off. Oh man, you're trying to get me to lose some sleep. But okay, Zach, I see you, bro.
The Innocent.
See, I might have to go back and see all these comments and take some of your guys' suggestions. We love horror movies. Yeah, so.
Maybe around Halloween would be perfect.
Yeah, we love watching around Halloween. It gets really good. Yes, sir.
It just puts you in the mood, like ooh.
Lakers winning tomorrow. Yes, sir. Let's go. We got a Laker fan in the chat. Love to see it. Angel said, I think only healed people don't get sleep paralysis. Wait, what do you mean by healed people? What does that mean? Healed from what, man?
Your traumas. I don't know.
What are we healed of, man? Like, I don't have no sleep paralysis. So
I said, I think only healed people don't get sleep
paralysis. Yeah, talk to him, Serge. Serge had to get off real quick.
Stop Googling that.
I got bro in trouble with his girl. Yeah. Just messing with you. It's all love, Brody.
He's no longer commenting. Must be true.
Bro got the bro out here trying to you know, he's trying to light up all the little smokes and trying to get out the succubus to come through the window.
Probably got in trouble with this girl.
He said with sleep paralysis, you have to relax and let it happen low key, because if you panic, You can't breathe or move. You try to talk and no one hears you. Oh,
yep. Man. You know what I do when that happens? That those times that it has happened to me, I would pray.
Listen, if that happens to me, fam, I'm squealing like a pig. Ain't no way I'm just going to let it happen. I'm going to squeal like a damn pig, bro. It's raps. Mr. Holden.
Hey, yo.
He said, I don't think you will be disappointed. I can't wait to watch a lot of these, man.
Mm-hmm.
Just a question. What's your favorite video game? All time? If this is an all-time question, it would probably be The Legend of Zelda, man. Ocarina of Time or A Link to the Past. Because I grew up on that. Like, I remember playing A Link to the Past on Super Nintendo with all my brothers and just trying to figure out the puzzles and the dungeons and shit. That was a blast. Anything I could do with my family or with my friends was great. Second favorite video game of all time, Street Fighter 2. I love fighting games. What about you, mm-hmm. baby?
I like Minecraft. No, I'm just playing. Roblox. Game. Yeah, right.
She ain't never
no,
played that.
I do like Street Fighter and all the classic Mario games.
Yep. We constantly play Street mm-hmm. Fighter all the time, fam. The classic, right? As a matter of fact, we got to do some gaming.
Oh, I love gaming episodes again. Smash Bros.
Oh, Smash Bros.
I yes, just sir. Grew up on that, playing it almost every day.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But from, you know, for the Nintendo 64.
You should have some wine while telling us scary stories. Hey, scary stories are always fun. If we get enough likes, we're going to have to do a part two to this, man, because this is always fun. You guys voted for it on Twitter, so yeah. I was like, either we're going to do relationship talk, we're just going to do bullshit Q&A talk,
or
scary stories, or any suggestions, we're open to it, man. If you guys have any topics, like, we really want to make this a staple, but it's all on you guys.
You can even come here and, like, you know, comment like any worries or concerns that you may have, and we can try to give you advice. That'd be perfect to know.
Big facts. Yeah, we might have some call-ins in the future. You never know. Getting a big enough support group for this is gonna get bigger. The Lord's healing is what I mean. That's right, my mm-hmm, boy. Mm-hmm. That's why I flex on him, but I don't think it has nothing to do with that, honestly. No, that sleep paralysis is scary for real.
Bro, there he is.
There he is.
What is sleep paralysis?
Don't ask, brother. Don't ask. You don't want to find out. I promise you that. I promise you that. Great podcast. Appreciate you, man.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys. Let's see. You're awake, but your body is asleep. There you go. He just explained it to you. Perfect. And I don't even know how that's possible, fam. Which tells me there is an afterlife.
When you can't move or talk, you are up. Mm-hmm.
And sometimes you see shit too. That's what I heard.
Oh, whatever you do, never go to the Appalachian Mountains alone. Oh, I've heard of that. What's up there? What?
You went
what
up there,
on?
Bro?
What goes on?
And you live to tell the tale?
What goes on in those mountains? Let me look. Because you know what? I've heard of it. Let me see. Let me look it up.
Seen any scary movies this year? Yeah, the one I was just talking about. Oh, that was last year, actually. I don't think I actually have. I wanted to go see Late Night with the Devil, but they weren't showing it in my theater for whatever reason. So I took it as a sign. I was like, maybe that shit's going to let something in that I don't want in here, so I'm not going to watch. But when it comes out, I definitely will watch it. Make it make sense. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
They weren't showing in my local theater, and I was not trying to drive 20 miles to go watch it. So, yeah. But I heard that was a good movie. Have y'all seen it?
What?
Late Night with the Devil.
Late Night with mm-hmm. the Devil. Oh. You said it got a high rating, huh?
Yep.
We tried to watch it, but, you know, they didn't have it here.
My guy said praying definitely works. It worked for me. Oh, for sure. Yeah. Listen, listen, praying works for me, man. Like, mm-hmm. God doesn't always give you what you want, but he always gives you what you need. Mm-hmm. You feel me? So prayers definitely work, fam. I've been blessed. This channel has been a blessing. It's been one of my prayers. So mm-hmm. prayers definitely work for sure. And God is the GOAT, the true GOAT. People mm-hmm. call me the GOAT, but the real GOAT, that's the man upstairs, man.
Mm-hmm.
Minecraft music be hitting, to be honest. I never played that game just because the pixels look weird to me.
I was just playing when I said Minecraft.
Yeah, it looks too choppy. I'm like, I can't, bro. I'm going to go blind playing this shit. I just, Maybe when I was a kid, it would have attracted me, but not no more. Let's see here. Dan, you should do scary stories with us on camera with you and your girl. What do you think?
Maybe one day.
Yeah, for sure, man. My girl feels comfortable right now, like, you know, doing this podcast because we don't even have to set up the room. You know what I'm saying? Like, the room's a mess right now. I don't even have to put up the green screen. We could just do it whenever. So that's why. But in the future, yeah, we'll definitely do something like that, bro. Sounds good. Or maybe you guys would just come on as guests and you don't even have to turn on your camera. You could just pop up and give your opinions on stuff.
We should do that where you bring on people and they tell the stories if they have any.
I mean, if y'all have any good stories, I could drop the link right now. There really is no limit to these podcasts. Yeah. We can go till we can't no mo. Mm-hmm. So if you got anything that you want to talk about, I could drop the link. Just let me know. Mm-hmm. Smash Bros is fun with a group of friends.
Yeah,
I love any fighting game with a group of friends. Remember when all the kids from the neighborhood came and tried to beat me at Dragon Ball Z?
Yeah.
Tell them who dominated.
You. Dtlf.
Well, they couldn't believe it. They was hating on me, Loki. You can see the anger in their eyes. And shit. But no, those are my friends. They were cool. Mm-hmm. The Conjuring is my favorite horror movie of all time. For reals? Mm-hmm. What is my favorite horror movie of all time? I don't think I have one.
My favorite of all time?
Yours is The Ring, right?
No.
No?
No, that was the first horror movie I've ever seen.
Yeah.
That, like, gave me nightmares. Nap after work used to give me that sleep paralysis. There you go.
Bro was just tired.
There you go.
Bro was so tired, his spirit was trying to leave and take take a vacation. She.
He didn't want to be at Amazon.
Dan. All right, Dan, this is out of subject, but give me your top five favorite rappers. Man, that's really hard to go off the top. But I'll give you with some of the ones that I grew up on. And it's going to be, again, give me 1 second here. So top five favorite rappers. I'm not going to go all the time. I'm just going to go off top five favorite rappers now, like current, because it's easier. If I go all the time, I got to think night and day. But current favorite rappers right now, I'm going to start J. Cole. I'm going to go Kendrick, K. Dot. I'm going to do 21 Savage. I still like MF Doom. I still listen to some of his stuff. And number five, I mean, you got to go with Pac. He's an old timer, but I bump his stuff now and in the past. And by the way, I never really liked Biggie, you know what I'm saying? And it's not because of the Tupac versus Biggie feud. I just never liked him. And I've had arguments with my friends about why I don't like him, but his style, his flow was like, just, I'm not a fan of, you know what I'm saying? It's like too, no disrespect, you know, RIP, but too lethargic for me, too slow, too, you know what I'm saying? I like aggressive rap, or I like, it has to have a good rhythm to it, like a good beat to it. Like, it has to get, that. Not only do they have to drop bars and have, and obviously be able to spit, but you have to come correct. Like, I don't even listen to Eminem because I'm not a huge fan of his voice. I know it sounds weird, but like the squeaky voice, like nowadays, everybody want to talk like they got something to say. Like, that shit is
you kind of sound like him.
No, that like, that's like maybe when I was a teenager, but I'm grown and I'm trying to listen to some real shit. You feel me? That's a good question.
Die Hard. Sleep paralysis has nothing to do with the devil or demons or unhealed.
Wait, my bad. I actually moved it.
It's when your heart and body are out of sync with rapid eye movements cycle.
Facts. That's what I was saying. I don't think it has nothing to do with what my guy Angel was saying. But it's wishful thinking, right?
Man, there was one time, do you remember? I want to say it was sleep paralysis. The one time I couldn't breathe.
Yeah.
Like, I felt like something was on top of me.
Yeah.
When you dropped me off at my mom's house, it was like past midnight. It was late at night. Everyone was asleep.
She felt like somebody was on top of her, and it wasn't me. So that's a problem. We having problems now.
Babe, it's not like that. No.
She was enjoying that spirit.
No, that night, like, I had just knocked out, and like shortly after, like, I felt like something was like on, like, literally, like, I won't even say on top of me in that case, because you're just going to twist it.
Yeah.
But I couldn't breathe. And then finally, when I woke up, I was like scared. I told my mom, I was like, "Mom, this happened." And then she's like, "Oh my God, you need to pray."
Facts. Yeah. What is my favorite horror movie? I don't have a favorite. I have a bunch I like. Like, I like Hills Have Eyes. Like I said, I like Sleepy Hollow. You know, there's a bunch. There's a bunch of horror movies I like. I don't have one specific favorite one that like stands above the rest. Mm-hmm. But if you ask me about a different genre, then I can give it to you.
What upcoming movie are you looking forward to watching this year?
You have one, babe?
I know you said you wanted to watch
Deadpool?
Yeah, Deadpool.
Deadpool is probably the one I'm most excited for. Yeah, Deadpool probably, man. Yeah, probably Deadpool. Yes, sir. But there was another one too, remember?
Which one?
The one we talked about earlier, The Quiet Place, the new one that's coming out. That's going to be a banger too, yep.
What's it called? Day One?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah,
Day One. I don't remember.
Something like that.
To be honest. Yeah. It's just
the terrific stories. Praying for all good night. Absolutely, Katrina. Absolutely, everybody. Please do not have nightmares. Just know that this is like pass by talk. It's nothing that we're trying to.
It's all fake, guys. I'm just kidding.
He said, facts, amen, God, the best. Big facts.
Yes.
Yes, sir. I love Jesus Christ. Me too, brother. Me too.
Mm-hmm.
I can't say a curse word after saying I love Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I'll say, F yeah, Dan. Love this podcast. Late night phone calls with Dan and his girl.
Yes, sir. Hey, we might do that, man. If you guys want to have any stories to tell, I'll open up the lines real quick. You don't even have to put on the camera. The blurry pixelated Facebook videos of Mexico at night be the scariest.
Yeah.
Oh, this is a good question right here. Dan, are you interested in Area 51? Okay. For the purpose of staying alive, I'm going to have to say no. You feel me? We're trying to get slayed out here, man. The government get a hold of this thing.
I'll never see Dan again.
He's too curious, man. He's too curious.
Yeah.
Sleep paralysis does happen from being too tired. Mm. Damn. That's crazy.
Think so?
He said, nah, I feel like somebody laying on top of you for real.
No.
That's horrible. Oh my God. I might bust a nut if that ever happens to me then. Somebody lay on top of me, bro? The Conjuring has got to be top 10 movies. It's a good movie for sure.
Dr. Dre is my favorite old school rapper.
Yeah, we're talking old school. The list sounds a lot different. And of course, the top five is hard because you leave out a lot of good artists. Like, I like Future too. There's so many artists I like. I listen to. I literally do not even have, like, I don't listen to albums. I listen to a playlist, my own personal playlist. And it plays like a cycle of the music I like, which is new stuff and old stuff combined.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it does. Definitely a Lakers fan. Only stop using Logic. It's scary time.
Facts. Let's see. Yes, please subscribe, man. Listen, late night is going to take off all summer long, especially when the Lakers offseason is here. We're going to be going deep into conversation. We're going to be talking about topics that are trending, new topics, old topics, everything. Everything goes.
Mm-hmm.
DMX is one of the tops, man. Listen, God rest his soul. I love DMX. He was amazing. It does feel like someone on top of you, they call that?
They call?
The Hag? Damn.
The Hag?
DMX, great storyteller. Love DMX, man. Said, is a scary movie be called?
And so this is a scary movie be called?
Yeah, I'll open up the lines if y'all trying to tell a story.
Yeah, you guys got to tell a story.
You got to tell a good story or it's going to be a snooze fest. All right, here, no shit. Like, I went to Chuck E. Cheese and the rat was looking at me. I love artists that paint a picture in their music. Me too. I love all kinds. See, there's different kinds of artists. There's storytellers. Mm-hmm. There's gangster rap. There's trap music. There's club music. There's love hip hop music. It's just so much diversity, and I just love rap. As long as he's a good rapper, I like it, and I respect it. Civil War is my go-to this year that I'm excited to see. Civil War? Oh, we're talking about the Marvel movie, right?
Mm.
Yeah, I forgot that was what it was going to be called. Oh, mixtape is getting scared now.
It's almost 1 a.m. here in M-Town. Let's keep it going, like with the scary story.
That boy's scared. Die Hard said, I've had it since I was a kid. I have plenty of stories and experiences, and I researched how to adjust, live with myself. It's a deep based on your mindset or spiritual awareness.
Wait, so you have it often or what?
Yeah, he just said it.
That's crazy.
He said he learned how to control it, man. Like, that's pretty cool. If you ever want to share the stories, bro, man. All right. I'm going to open up the line just in case anybody's interested, right? And you guys don't even have just to turn
stories.
On your camera.
I just want to hear stories.
You guys don't have to turn
it's
on your camera.
It's your guys' turn.
Let's go. Here goes. Let me go ahead and drop it right here. I'd love to hear a good story, man.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go. All right. The link is in the chat in the description. Let's go. Yeah, if they want me to open up the lines, you got it, bro. You know, I'm a man of the people, right? but yeah, the link is right there. You watched some Dodgers today? I watched them in parts. My guy Teoscar Hernandez, which I had predicted to my boy Mookie, man, that was going to have a good season. I just had a feeling that was going to be a great acquisition. And sure enough, man, I think he has 4 homers already. Bro, looks amazing. Oh, look at this shit. We got my boy King Jalen has entered the chat. What's up, brother?
What up?
First of all, I'm not scared.
He sounds scared.
I ain't gonna lie. My house is pitch black right now. I'm in my room, though. But
damn.
So I ain't gonna lie. My door locked, though.
Bro's door is locked. You know, by yourself or your company?
No, I'm by myself.
You know they can be in there with you, right? They could be in there with you.
Hey, they
sound like a young 20s.
If they in here with me, we just gonna be watching YouTube, Gil.
Hey, what if they start touching up on you, bro? What you gonna do? You gonna let it happen?
No.
Bro's just gonna turn around and unbuckle his pants, be like, "Oh, come on, then."
But seriously, hey, Dan.
Yeah.
Paralysis, hey, bro. That's so scary, bro.
I know, man.
One time I woke up, I'm like, bro, why I can't move?
Yeah.
And like Dawg was saying, I was laying on my back, but I don't sleep on my back. I normally sleep on my side. I'm like, bro, why I can't move? I couldn't talk. I'm like, bro. I said, but in my head, I'm like, at three, I'm gonna just try to make myself move.
Yeah. Oh man. So that happened to you, KJ? That's crazy, bro. You're brave for even telling us this story, especially since you have to sleep by yourself, man. That's crazy, bro.
Are you still there?
Oh, shit, they took him.
I'm here.
He went quiet for a second. Like, oh shit.
Probably because my phone,
You want to turn on the lights, huh?
No, I'm still in the dark.
Bro said you called in and have company in the dark. That's funny, bro.
No, I'm still in the dark. But actually my TV is on too, so.
Yeah. So check this out. Have you ever seen a dead body before?
No.
Besides at a funeral open casket.
I've seen a dead body before, man. I'm gonna be honest.
In a funeral?
No. In Compton.
In the streets, no.
I remember somebody got shot, and I remember seeing the dead body there, in Park Village. You know, I walked by it and I seen it, and I was like, I didn't understand what was going on. I was too young, right? But later on, when they told me he was dead, like he didn't make it, that's when I realized what I had just seen. And I also saw somebody get shot. It was my friend's stepdad. He got shot, but the bullet didn't really go through. It grazed his ear, and he was bleeding a lot. And he was overreacting, like he was dying and shit. And I remember the kids were all crying and everything. And he was bleeding a lot. Like, it cracked the windshield. He was sitting in his car, and somebody shot at him because he was a mechanic. Like, imagine a hood mechanic that doesn't do good work. You know what I'm saying?
Dang.
So, and he used to charge people big bucks, and they try to kill him, bro. They shot at him, but they missed. They only got him in his ear, and bro was like, you know, they Mike Tyson him. You know, and bro was like acting like he was dying and shit. So yeah, I mean, I did see some hood shit when I was a kid. Art says, did you go to Compton High? I did not go to Compton High. My older brothers did though. My older brothers did. I only went up to middle school there. No, actually to elementary school there. I went up to the fourth grade, fifth grade before I moved over here to the Inland Empire. So yeah, So I lived in Compton till I was like about 11. Let's see. Say it again.
No, I was thinking about that. What's the movie? La Llorona. That's what it's called. Llorona.
La Llorona.
Yeah. See, my girlfriend took me to go see it at the movies, and I'm just like,
Dude, the story's justice. I'll tell you that.
No, you see videos on YouTube about that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You said boys in the hood type shit. Yeah, bro. Like, it's crazy. In Compton, it was crazy. You know. It's crazy. Let's see. Did you? Oh, I already read that one. He said, nah, I've seen the cartel videos, if that counts. Oh, yeah, those are horrible, bro. Yeah. I probably taught them. So if anybody else has a scary story, man, I'd love to bring you on.
Right, hey, y'all got some? Because I don't. I mean, I'm here by myself.
Wait, I thought you were here for...
No, he did tell us the one about the sleep paralysis he had.
What do you think causes that? Do you have some sort of... what do you call it?
I ain't gonna lie. But you think... You know when y'all think y'all see something in the dark, but it's not really there?
Yeah.
One time, man, I ain't gonna lie, I'm laying in my bed...
Yeah,
I wake up in the middle of the night. You know, I probably was up for like probably 5 seconds and went back. I'm thinking somebody's standing in my room. I'm like, well, who the fuck is that? But I'm too damn lazy to get out the damn bed. It was just my damn gaming chair with my clothes on, like somebody just standing there. I'm like,
and those are always, it's always.
But you know what I'm talking about? It's some in your room. It just got something on it, like somebody just standing there. I'm like, what
the fuck? Yeah,
yeah, yeah, for and sure. That's always scary, man. I've felt many times like I was like somebody was watching me. I've had that happen, but obviously I don't talk about those occasions just because, you know, it doesn't really count as a horror story unless you've seen or experienced something, like, you know what I'm saying, like firsthand. My brother, man, both of my brothers, they have crazy stories, man. Like, I got a brother who said that it, obviously, you know, in Mexico, they live in poverty. So I think all three of two of my brothers and my sister all used to sleep in the same bed as kids, right? Mm-hmm. So, or something like that. And they had like a clown toy that was like the size of a kid, right? It was a little bigger.
Like a toddler.
And apparently, two of my brothers witnessed the clown pull my sister's hair off the bed.
Oh, fuck that shit.
Yeah, yeah, like that. Like that's something they all confirmed happened. So I believe them, right? But I believe this was in Mexico, if I'm not mistaken, right? Before they crossed the border.
I don't miss the spirits. Fuck that shit.
Yeah,
y'all can have them Ouija boards. Y'all can have all that shit.
Yeah, I don't mess with none of that either, bro. That's probably why we don't experience crazy shit.
Once you start messing with it, would you guys mess with it if you were offered $50 million?
Y'all can keep y'all $50 million.
hold on. Who in the chat would mess with a Ouija board for $50 million?
You ain't gonna be allowed to see it.
I'm curious who would sell their soul, man. That's basically the question. Right there. Yeah.
But I ain't gonna lie, damn, when my girl, when she used to work at the movie theater.
Yeah.
When what's the movie called? The Conjuring, the Annabelle stuff?
Yeah.
They was giving away life-size dolls of the Annabelle.
Hell no.
Man, I was like, it was like, when I say life-size, it was probably about my height, Dan, like your height, 6 feet, little statue. I said, Stephen, you think they'll let me have one? Because they were just giving them away. She said, if I give you that, I'm breaking up with you. You ain't going to never see me again. I said, all right.
facts. And we got my guy, Art. Let's see if I say this right. No Stall TV. What's up, bro?
What's up?
Your new style. How's it going, you guys?
No, pretty good, man. Pretty good.
I've been watching the show for a while.
Ooh. Appreciate that, man.
Yeah, man. When you mentioned that you're from Compton, that's when I had to subscribe, because I've been teaching at Compton for 25 years.
Oh, man, that's so awesome.
I taught at the Centennial and Compton. I taught at Centennial and Compton.
Nice.
Awesome, bro.
So well, I must have
on to the show, bro. It was a pleasure having you on board.
And I've been pushing Lakers everywhere I went. So everybody knows that I'm the teacher that wears Lakers shirts on Laker Day.
Yo,
awesome.
You're the goat, man. You're the goat for that.
But the one that I can probably share for the most part, and I think the brother was talking about the sleep paralysis.
Man,
I was, you know, like I don't know if I was waking up, but I felt like something was grabbing my foot and I couldn't move.
Yeah,
and I couldn't scream.
Did you ask what room this was in? Like, what room did it happen in?
Your bedroom.
Right.
My bedroom.
Is it like downstairs, upstairs? Is it just?
I just have a single family home, one story.
Was that the only occasion?
And it was
the only first time. Or has it happened?
I think so. And I read about dreams too. So I try, because they're usually some kind of interpretation of, actually, from what I've read, it's supposed to be an answer to a physical problem.
Oh.
So
it's like a psychological.
If you can't get anybody to give you some good advice, then the answers are usually in your dreams, but the only issue is that your dreams are in symbols. So how are you going to read symbols as far as your answer to your problem unless you study this stuff?
Right. Mm-hmm. And let me ask you a question, my guy. Do you believe in life after death?
sort of like a reincarnation in a way.
No, like heaven and hell,
in that sense.
Yeah,
I do.
I get more into spirit, to mainly where you have a cup, like our body is a cup. or that holds a cup, and the spirit is in the cup, if that makes sense. And so your cup could be your body or your soul, but whatever goes in that cup goes in and out. So you can have good spirits, bad spirits. You have mineral spirits for people drinking, you know, all that kind of stuff. Yeah. So I think once, you know, once the cup is used up and as its purpose or whatever, that spirit travels.
Wow.
It goes somewhere else.
Okay.
And I make use of that. So I think it's, I mean, that's the way I look at it. You know, yeah. But life after the death stuff or whatever.
Yeah.
I don't know. I could probably just look at it from a different standpoint, though.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I guess everybody will find out when their time comes. Yeah, but I guess that's when we'll know. But man, so you say you felt something pulling at your leg, and then what happened after that?
It took me a while to wake up. And then I finally did, but it took a while because I couldn't move.
Yeah.
And I'm like, wow. I couldn't even scream for help.
I told you, Dan, you can't talk.
I couldn't do it.
Right there, KJ. That's awesome. That's crazy. Wow. Yeah, I can't imagine.
And the other creepiest one I probably had is I dreamed about my... And I think the one other creepiest one I had is when I dreamed about my wife before meeting her.
What?
That was weird.
So you
yeah.
actually?
Oh, y'all want to hear it?
Yeah, absolutely.
See, you must have a delay.
Yeah,
a little bit of a delay. This is like 2015. I dreamed about this lady with curly hair and big eyes and bright skin. And that lady was looking at me on the side of my bed, just staring at me with, and I'm like, what? And then there was another lady that was laying on the left side of my body, but she was dark.
Yeah.
And it seemed like she didn't have any life.
Ooh. Wow.
Okay. And so... So a year later, the same lady that was staring at me looked just like my wife. My wife was from Brazil. She wow. looked just like her. Wow. And so that year I met her. The following year, my mom died, and my mom is dark skinned.
Oh,
dang.
So
crazy.
That was the weirdest thing. I wrote that dream down, by the way, to make sure that I wasn't crazy.
So that's no wonder, know, man. You study dreams and all of that because you've had some experiences, my friend. That pretty much, I mean, so validify a lot of what people, you know, believe are theories. So that's pretty. I mean, in a way, it's cool, and in a way, it's a little scary as well. So, how do you cope with all of this, man? How do you just deal with these dreams and like, is it uncomfortable knowing that you might have a crazy dream at night, or is it just you just accept it for what it is?
No, I'm used to it. I'm used to it because you have to try to, you know, they got something called dream catchers.
Yeah.
So you got to try to remember as much details as possible and write it down when you wake up, and then, you know, start researching things about like symbols, like what colors mean, what do, like, for example, anything bright means spirit, anything dark means physical. You know, I mean, just little stuff like that.
Yeah.
And you got to start putting those pieces, those puzzles together to try to figure out what was this about, you know,
and only you know.
I mean, a lot of people can't tell you about your dreams. Only you know about your dreams.
Yeah. Wow. That's an impressive story you just told us, man. Thank you for sharing that with us. We appreciate that. That kind of made the whole video.
Not a...
I know.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely, man.
Listen, I've just been listening for a while. It's like,
I love hearing stories like that. Because
so hopefully we can have a.
Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, I'm sorry, delay. I said, hopefully we can dream about this championship so we can have 18 instead of 17. Yes.
That's right.
And make it a reality.
Absolutely, my friend. Oh, my
God. I'm getting tired of this 17-17. Somebody got to step up and take these Celtics out so they won't be over our head all day, you know?
Yeah, absolutely, man. Hey, shout out to you, Art, and Last question, man. May I ask what grade you teach?
I teach, when I was at Compton, I'm in LA right now, but when I was teaching at Compton Unified, I was teaching 9th through 12th grade. I was there because I was trying to figure out, I'm not sure if you look like your brothers, but I was teaching at Compton from 2002 to 2022.
2002.
That's when I was at Compton.
Let me see. I think my brother, let me see if my brothers maybe still went there at that time. I don't know if you might remember their names or not.
If they went there, they definitely know me.
Okay.
Like if they went there, they know me. Okay. They know me because I was all over the place. I was very active.
One of them probably took my class.
I don't know. But
I don't know if you want to share your name with us, but I'd love to know and ask them.
Yeah, I can't throw my name out there.
Okay, that's fair.
If you talk to them, they'll definitely tell you who I am.
For sure, man.
They'll definitely tell you who I am because I'm the last of the Mohicans. I'm the only I'm the only type of teacher that does this stuff, man. So
awesome.
But yeah, man, I appreciate you having me up and keep doing what you're doing, man. And I'll just keep supporting you, brother. And maybe one day you do another one of these, we can share some more stories.
Absolutely, man. You're welcome on anytime, man. It was an absolute pleasure having you, man. Thank you for blessing the channel with your stories. And we hope to hear more from you, Art. Have a good night, all right?
A good night.
Well, thank you. All right. Take care. I got to get ready for these other children tomorrow. So
all right, here we go. Brother.
Appreciate you, brother.
Thanks for the support. All right, brother. Peace.
Okay. Oh, this is scary.
That was cool, bro. We got a really cool story about how he like kind of had a premonition about his wife and his mom. Oh my goodness, bro.
Yeah, man.
That's crazy,
bro. You know how scared I'd be. Look to your left and somebody just light bulb. Hell no.
Man, but you know what, man? Props to him for sharing that. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes these stories are really personal, man. And you know what's crazy? My brothers, I believe they did go to Compton High around that time. I don't remember the exact year when they graduated, but I will be asking them to watch this episode towards the end and to see if they, they recall any of this, man. But man, what a banger episode we just had, man. You guys definitely chose a good episode, man, to come out and participate. So I appreciate you, man. Thank you, KJ, as well for joining us, man. I think we're going to end it right here. We got to end it on that story, man.
Yep.
We got to go out with a bang, my friend. And
hopefully... I ain't no punk, chat.
He said, I ain't no punk. Well, hopefully, man, you sleep good. And
y'all too.
if you're lucky, you'll get a succubus to visit you tonight.
Nah. Hopefully, I get a Laker girl.
Oh man. All right, man. Thank you so much for joining, KJ. Appreciate you, bro. Have a good night, all right?
Y'all have a good night too.
All right, brother. Much love, man. And to the rest of the chat as well, man. Thank you guys. We had an absolute pleasure doing late night.
Awesome episode.
The guy really just made my night kind of.
And thank you to all those that stuck through it.
Yeah, thank you guys for sticking through. I think this is almost two hours. I think this is the most we've had on a late night episode. So please make sure you guys hit the like button if you guys want more of these soon. Okay, we get 150. We might come back tomorrow night for sure. If not, the subsequent day. But we'll make it happen. All right. And if you guys have any suggestions for what type of episode you guys would like next, we are all ears.
Yep.
So make sure you leave it in the comment section. Hit the like.
Mm-hmm.
We appreciate you guys. Please have a good night.
Thank you. And everyone have a good night.
And try to get some good sleep. All right. Nobody be scared. All right, y'all. Peace out, man.